For the final time, as the play-by-play voice of the Carolina Thunderbirds, I'm Drew Blevins, joined by the voice-elect of the Carolina Thunderbirds, Dylan Clark. Dylan, first of all, welcome to the team. How does it feel to be in Winston-Salem?
I'm extremely excited. This is what I was looking forward to pretty much my whole time in college, and to actually be here and to have it happening, it's thrilling.
We're very excited to have you alongside the Thunderbirds organization. You'll be the fourth play-by-play voice in team history, and immediately Dylan becomes the youngest play-by-play voice in the FPHL. Tell the folks at home a little bit about yourself, your college career, and what were the steps to get you here?
Well, I actually didn't know that youngest in the FPHL part, but I spent 4 years at the University of South Carolina as the voice of Gamecock Hockey. Did some time with men's and women's soccer and softball at the university as well with SEC Network Plus, and graduated 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. So quick turnaround time here, but I'm really excited about it.
And for the folks at home, you're not a native North Carolinian. You're originally from the state of Pennsylvania up in Pittsburgh, a huge Penguins fan. What's the transition been like growing up in Pennsylvania, coming to school in South Carolina, and then making the jump north to the better Carolina, North Carolina?
It was a bit of a jump, especially early freshman and sophomore year, Pittsburgh down to South Carolina. But over the last couple of years, you know, it's become more like home for me, and I don't think it'll be too different going back up from South Carolina to North Carolina.
And for the folks at home, what are some of the things that you like to bring to your call? What are some of your goals that you have here in Winston-Salem, and what are you bringing to the table for the team?
Well, one of the conversations we had in the beginning was just, you know, kind of adding more tools to the toolbox, and I think that's one of the primary things that I'll be looking to do. And as far as calling a game, I just telling the story as accurately as possible, as completely as possible, and just being able to draw people in, because I have a ton of fun watching these games, I have a ton of fun calling these games, and I try to make that as infectious as possible, because if you're not having as much fun watching it as I am, I'm doing something wrong, so.
Anything else the folks at home should know about you before they get a chance to hear your voice throughout the summer and then leading up to that first game?
I don't think so. I just the excitement, it's hard to contain, you know, and the quick turnaround right out of college. You know, I wasn't expecting to land in such a fortunate position so quickly, but I'm really excited.
We're excited to have Dylan Clark as the new play-by-play voice of the Carolina Thunderbirds. We're going to have a quick costume change, and then he'll officially have his first duty as play-by-play voice of the FPHL's Carolina Thunderbirds.
Well, welcome back. This is voice-elect of Carolina Thunderbirds now with the voice of the Fayetteville Marksman, Drew Blevins. Quick wardrobe change. We're back in action here, so your turn, Drew. You're in a new role. You're in a new city. What are your thoughts going into this new job opportunity?
I mean, very similar to you. I'm excited for this opportunity. I'm excited to go to a great organization in Fayetteville, a chance for me to stay in my home state. The Marksmen are in an interesting position. They didn't have an opportunity to play hockey last year, so they've gone dark a whole season. They were second in the SPHL, pushing for the first overall spot when the COVID-19 pandemic shut the entire organization down, the entire SPHL. So to go to an organization that has a history of great hockey success, and now an organization that's having turnover in their staff and bringing in new young blood with fresh ideas, is a great opportunity and something I'm looking forward to tremendously.
So you're making that jump one league up into the SPHL. Is it kind of give you that same feeling as when you got to the FPHL? Is it that same kind of like, all right, we're going to step up now?
Well, when I got to the FPHL, I realized this was a chance to get into professional hockey, still unaffiliated hockey, but it's professional nonetheless. So I'm one of 120 broadcasters in the United States that's doing professional hockey games. And now for me to get the chance to go to the SPHL, the next step above this is in an affiliated NHL pipeline. And you know as well as I do, that's what everybody's working toward, is you want to make it to the NHL one day. It's just a step in the right direction.
You spent countless hours in this arena, in this office, calling games here at the fairgrounds. What has all that time meant to you personally, and to your development as a broadcaster as well?
And I was thinking about this the other day and speaking with General Manager Kelly Curl. This is the organization that gave me my shot. They took a risk on a 24-year-old kid coming out of Wake Forest, North Carolina, that was a high school teacher at the time that I took this job, and to come in here and have a chance to develop my skills, the creative space that the Thunderbirds allowed me to have. I cannot put into words how grateful I am. And the thing about this, and you'll understand this once the season gets underway and you get to meet these fine people and these great fans here in Winston-Salem, there's nothing like walking up that outward-facing facade, getting into the body of the arena, seeing the red and the black and the white, feeling the buzz of this crowd, and then going up and calling a game and performing your best and telling the story of each and every game for these great fans. I will forever be grateful to the people here in this office, to the ownership group, the general manager, and all of my colleagues, and also the fans, the players, and the coaching staff for being so wonderful to me. It's going to be something that I will, while I'm looking forward to this new opportunity, it's going to be something that I'm going to miss about this great place and this great city.
Well, Drew, the line that's been repeated to me over and over since I've been here is big shoes to fill. So I look forward to filling them, and I wish you the best in your endeavors, and I hope to see you around pretty soon.
Thank you so much.
So for all of us here at Carolina Thunderbirds TV with Drew Blevins, my name is Dylan Clark. Thank you so much. We'll see you around.